previous session in which we have learned some characteristics of particles of matter. Okay, so three characteristics we have learned. First one is that particles are having space in between them. Then the particles are moving continuously. In that we have learned about diffusion and one matter, that is about temperature, low temperature and high temperature. And the last one we have learned about that the particles attract each other. Okay, so that is the force of attraction. Now in this session we are going to compare three states of matter. Okay, that are solids, liquids and gases. Okay, as we have learned characteristics, now you will gain idea of these three states of matter easily. So one by one, by comparison, we will learn about these three states. Got it? I think already you have learned about solid and liquid. Okay, so let's start with comparison. So first one is that shape. Okay, so see, I have written many properties here: shape, volume, flow, rigidity, compressibility and diffusion. Okay, already we have learned about the particles arrangement. Okay, in solids the particles are in compact nature. In liquid there is a more space in between the particles. And in gases the particles are everywhere. Okay, most space is available in the particles of gases. Then we have learned that in solid the maximum force of attraction due to this kind of arrangement. Then we have learned here is less force of attraction as compared to the solids. And in gases there is no force of attraction as the particles are everywhere. Okay, no control on these particles. Okay, so here one by one we will see. So first property is about shape. So this shape is, all these properties are depend upon the arrangement of particles, the characteristics of particles. So the solids are having definite shape. See the blackboard, your wall, textbook, mobile, then chalk, dustbin, all are the examples of solids. And these solids are having a definite shape. Means your clock is in circle, your board is in rectangle, it is in a, what we can say, the cylindrical shape, your book is in a square shape. So like that, the solids are having definite shape, okay, a proper shape. But in case of liquids, they are not having definite shape. Okay, if you can do one example, means one activity. Take two glasses of water, okay. Put one glass, means put the water in one plate, put the water in one glass, another glass. Or you can say a different kind of, different shape of plate. Means you can see here, one plate is like this, one plate is like this. Okay, and if you are putting the water on both plates, in both plates, what will happen? The water will take the shape of this square. Here the water will take the shape of this plate. Means what? Water is not having proper shape. Means we cannot say that, ah, water is in a circle shape, water is in a square shape. No. Water is not having a definite shape. Instead of that, water takes the shape of container. Means in which container we are putting the water, okay, water will take the shape of that container. Like the plate is in square shape, so the water will take the shape of square. Here, circle. So like that, there is no definite shape in liquids, but they are taking the shape of the container. And then gases. Again, see the arrangement of particles. Particles are everywhere. Correct? Means one is here, one is here, one is here, one is here. Okay? Now we will make a boundary. Okay? Okay, then here. So can you tell me is shape? We cannot tell because gases, particles are present everywhere and we cannot take a proper shape. So in gases, we will write no definite shape. Got it? Yes. Next is about volume. Okay. So as the solids are having definite shape, that having definite volume also. Okay. Now volume means what? How much space occupied by that object? So that is volume. Okay. So solids are having definite volume. Liquids are also having definite volume. Means we can say that 1 kg of sugar, 5 kg of rice. Here we can measure the liquid material in liter, in milliliter. Means what? If these objects are having units, these objects are having definite volume. So the definite volume is in solids and in liquids. What about gas? Are we going to measure the gas? Go to the shop and bring 1 kg of oxygen. Bring 1 liter of carbon. Like we are saying, no. Because the gases are having, means they are not having the definite volume. Got it about shape and volume? You have to write this chart in your notebook, okay? So first take the screenshot. So by writing you can understand this properly. Taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So I hope that you have taken the screenshot. Now next property is about flow and rigidity. Okay? Means can that object flow? Now flow, that what is the meaning of flow that you know? Okay? So solids cannot flow. Okay? If this is a duster, correct? This is a solid. Example of solid. And if I am putting that duster on the ground, that duster will start to flow. Is it? No. Because the particles are in compact nature, so solids cannot flow. But in case of rigidity, yes, solids are rigid. Now what is mean by rigidity? Write with pencil, huh? Here you can write with pencil. What is mean by rigidity? So rigidity is one kind of ability to retain or maintain the shape in case of external force. Means see, this is a mold, this is a solid. Now I am starting to apply the force. Okay? Can I change the shape of this mold? Can I change? No. Means what? This kind of solids are having ability to retain or maintain the shape in case of external force. So that is your rigidity. Okay. So see again the arrangement, compact nature, so the solids are rigid. Got it? Next see, liquid. Now that rigidity is not in case of liquid and gases because they are not having ability to retain their shape. Okay? Because they are not having definite shape. Got it? So rigidity is only in case of solid, so it is easy to remember. If they are not having definite shape, they cannot retain their shape again. So rigidity is only for solids. In liquid and in gases, there is a flow property. Okay? So liquids and gases can flow easily. See, air is flowing, liquid is flowing. Easy, because there is a space in between the particles. So these liquids and gases can flow easily. And in science we are saying that fluids. Okay? See. Liquids and gases are also called as fluids. Okay? Next one is compressibility. Now compressibility means what? We have to compress. We have means after applying the pressure, we have to compress that substance. So see, it is a compact in nature. So can we compress? No. So here, compressed natural gas, CNG. Means after applying the pressure, what we are doing? Molecules are everywhere. See, now imagine this is your container. Molecules of that gas are there. So after applying the pressure, we are binding that molecules to each other. So like that, we can compress the gases easily by applying pressure. Okay? Here no compressibility, no. Here yes. Okay? And the last one is diffusion. Now tell me, what will happen in diffusion? Diffusion. When will happen diffusion? When there are spaces, then there is a diffusion. In solid, spaces are there, but very less space. That's why the diffusion is very slowest in solids. Here, liquid we can add in solid. Liquid is gas. Okay, so here diffusion will happen, but not that much as happen in gases. Means fastest diffusion is happen only in gases, because space is more. We can include or we can add, we can fill anything in that space. Got it? So like that, there are many properties I have given here, and here we have completed our three states of matter with one table. So like that, you have to learn all the things. Now you are in 9th standard. First solids, then do the rote learning, write the points, rote learning, remember that things. No. Now with logic, with technique, you have to learn all the things, all the terms. Now see, in one table we have learned three states of matter. Okay? So like that, start to prepare your own notes. Start to read that notes. Okay, stop rote learning. बुक लेके बैठना है, सिर्फ टीचर ने ये कहा है, वो कहा है, वो रट्टा मार रहा है, ये सब नहीं करना. व्हाट इट? सो डू योर स्टडी लाइक दिस. नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्क्रीनशॉट राइट द टेबल इन योर नोटबुक. नाउ हाउ टू राइट? ओके, यूज लाइक दिस पेजेस, दिस एंड दिस. ओके, ऑन दिस टू पेजेस draw this table, write down the points, and then learn that. Still, stay home, stay safe, and thank you.